May I request permission to commence the proceedings, my lord?
Yes.
Authorization. Arif Muhammad Khan, Governor of Kerala, Taj Bhavan, Thiruvananthapuram, 695099, Order, 21st May 2020. By virtue of the provisions of Article 219 of the Constitution of India,
I, Arif Muhammad Khan, the Governor of Kerala, do hereby appoint Sri Justice S. Manikumar, Chief Justice High Court of Kerala, to administer the oath or affirmation in the form set out for the purpose in the third schedule of the Constitution of India, to Sri Karunakaran Meenan Haripal, appointed as additional judge in the High Court of Kerala, before he enters upon his office. Signed, Arif Muhammad Khan. Warrant of appointment. By virtue of the power vested in me by clause 1 of Article 224 of the Constitution of India, I, Ramnath Kovind, President of India, do hereby appoint Sri Karunakaran Meenan Haripal to be an additional judge of the Kerala High Court with effect from the day he assumes charge of his office till 8 May 2022. Given at Rashtrapati Bhavan, New Delhi, this 20th day of May in the year 2020, 30th Vaishakha 1942 Sarga, in the 71st year of the Republic of India. Signed, President of India.
I, Karunakaran Meenan Haripal,
having been appointed additional judge of the High Court of Kerala,
having been appointed additional judge of the High Court of Kerala,
do swear in the name of God,
do swear in the name of God,
that I will bear true faith and allegiance to the Constitution of India as by law established,
that I will bear true faith and allegiance to the Constitution of India as by law established,
that I will uphold the sovereignty and integrity of India,
that I will uphold the sovereignty and integrity of India,
that I will duly and faithfully and to the best of my ability, knowledge and judgment,
that I will duly and faithfully and to the best of my ability, knowledge and judgment,
perform the duties of my office without fear or favour, affection or ill will,
perform the duties of my office without fear or favour, affection or ill will,
and that I will uphold the Constitution and the laws,
and that I will uphold the Constitution and the laws.
Honorable the Chief Justice, Mr. Justice S. Manikumar, Honorable Judges, Honorable Mr. Justice K. Haripal, President of the Kerala High Court Advocates Association, Mr. R. Lakshminarayanan, President of the Senior Advocates Association, Mr. M. L. Sumadharan, President of the Federation of Women Lawyers, Srimadi S. K. Devi, Registrars of Army Registry and other registrars, Wife Mr. Justice K. Haripal, Srimati Maya Haripal and other dignitaries present. We have assembled here today to welcome into our midst Honorable Mr. Justice Haripal, who has just now sworn in as Judge of the Honorable Court. In his elevation to this exalted position, it is a unique personality with an excellent and meritorious record of dispensation of justice with the Supreme Judiciary that is becoming part of the prestigious constitutional institution, and the great galaxy of eminent judges who have brought everlasting glory and fame to it as one of the best high courts in the country. Born the son of the late Mr. late M. N. Karunakaran Nair and late M. N. Rukmini Amma, of the ancient agriculturist family of Malliyath Vaipod and Changanacheri, Justice Haripal has his early education in the Government Muslim LPI School Vaipod and NSS High School Kundamthanam. After his graduation in economics from Marthoma College, Thiruvallur, he took his law degree from Government Law College at Ernakulam in the year 1986 and entered judicial service as a state as judicial second class magistrate in the year 1987. Promoted as judicial first class magistrate in 1990, he was selected as Munshif in the year 1991. Thereafter, he had his promotion in the service as subordinate judge in 2002 and as district judge in 2005. During the period of about 33 years of eventful career in the subordinate judiciary, amongst other, he had also worked as Registrar of Kerala Lokayukta, as Enquiry Commissioner of Special Judge Vigilance, and as Chairman of the Administrative Committee of Sri Padmanabhaswamy Temple. In his capacity as Additional District Judge and District Judge, he had worked in different stations in the state at Ernakulam, Thrissur, Alappuzha, Kavarathi, and Thiruvananthapuram. While holding the post of Principal District Judge Thiruvananthapuram, he was appointed as Registrar of Subordinate Judiciary on 10-1-2018 and as Registrar General in the High Court on 5-11-2018. Definitively now, the rich and varied experience he had in Subordinate Judiciary at the state, the virtuous character and integrity for which he was highly reputed, coupled with the sharp intellect and deep training, paved for him the way to the prestigious position of Judge in High Court, to which he has just now been sworn in. At this moment, it is our proud privilege to welcome the celebrated understanding personality who carries with him the halo of a highly efficient and accomplished judicial officer into our midst. But then I reckon it not to be out of place to remind His Lordship that, and as a judge of the Constitutional Court, the field of law and the spheres of activity he has to tread, the manner and method he had to function in, and the nature and extent of the power he has to exercise are somewhat of a varied kind, which demands and calls for skills, approaches and visions of different nature compared to the one needed by and expected as a judicial officer of the subordinate judiciary. Mr. Justice Haripal, we are fully confident that you are bestowed with such rare and exceptional qualities in abundance, which will enable you to discharge the onerous functions of a judge of the High Court of this higher judiciary with great ease, exceptional merit, and that no satisfaction for consent. In a democratic federal polity that hovers, the role of the judiciary has to play is as a paramount importance. The preamble of the Constitution has guaranteed to the citizens, amongst other, justice, liberty, equality and fraternity, as detailed thereunder in unambiguous terms. There are three great instrumentalities or organs of the state, as we call it, which have to make this promise an authentic reality, thereby deciding the destiny of the nation and people. Mutual respect and consideration between these equally important organs have to be jealously kept and retained even while corrective measures, the task which is entrusted by the Constitution, are taken by the judiciary. With your Lordship's temperament, outlook and understanding of interesting constitutional concepts and legal principles, it is certain that this cardinal principle will be strictly adhered to in the discharge of your judicial functions. Judiciary has to be independent, but that independence postulated under the supreme law of the land is not merely from pressure of the executive or other sources, but also from personal prejudices and class considerations. The great words of Disraeli assumes importance in this context. I repeat that all power is a trust, that we are accountable for the exercise, that from the people and for the people all springs and we all must exist. The agonizing voice of the poor and the lowly and the deprived and the lost should be heard and listened to and in the most sympathetic manner. The philosophy embedded in the Constitution not only permits but even demands that then and then alone the cherished dream of the coveted concept of social justice will bloom in its full vigor and vitality in the social life. Even access to justice very often is often illusory, mirage to a considerable extension of those unfortunate dots. The creative mind or the visionary judge can acting within the bounds of law itself, find effective solution for it. That is the inevitable need of the time, and the judicial mind that wakes up to it will always remain in the hearts and minds of the people with reverential respect. As Aristotle said, all virtues is summed up in dealing justly. Justice Haribol, at this juncture, and we lawyers fraternity may like to remind you that the lawyers and judges are two equally important wheels of the chariot of justice, and it is the smooth and combined duration and revolution of the two that will lead to the glorious destinations. As a judicial officer, you have always been friendly and considerable to the bar, and being in the discharge of your assuming office as judge of the court, we welcome you in your midst with profound sentiments of joy, happiness, filled to the brim of our heart. Vaihu Haribol, Sri Maya Haribol is with us. His son, Sri Krishnan Haribol, engineer, is in Cherry Hills, Interiors, Bangalore. We welcome them, and also in our midst, Mr. Haribol. I, as part of the leader of the entire bar estate, assure you, Your Lordship, of the entire cooperation and assistance of the bar in the discharge of your functions as judge in Sangam Court. Thank you.
My Lord, Honorable Chief Justice Sri S. Manikumar, Justice K. Haribol, Honorable Companion Judges, Sri C. P. Sudhakar Prasad, the Learned Advocate General, Sri P. Vijay Kumar, Assistant Solicitor General of India, President of the Kerala High Court Senior Advocate Association, Sri N. N. Suganapalan, President of the Kerala Federation of Women Lawyers, Srimati S. K. Devi, Senior Standing Counsel, Government of Taxes, Government of India Taxes, Sri P. K. Ravindranath Menon, respected former judges, law officers of the Union and the State, respected senior advocates, lawyer friends, registrars of this honorable court, family members of His Lordship Justice K. Harilal, advocate clerks, staff of this honorable court, ladies and gentlemen. Today, we are assembled here to welcome the newly sworn in judge, Honorable Justice Sri K. Haribol. On behalf of the Kerala High Court Advocate Association, I extend to His Lordship a hearty and affectionate welcome. Perhaps His Lordship may be the first judge of this honorable court to get a swearing in ceremony televised on an online live streaming. We are living in a challenging times, but this too shall pass. Just like others, the judicial world is also undergoing a change. These days, court proceedings are happening through video conferencing. Also, virtual court is becoming a reality. We are traversing through one of the most difficult terrains of part of our life. We can say with certainty that changes that are evolving from the demands of these extraordinary times will have far-reaching effects on the profession of law and administration of justice. There will be certainly a paradigm shift. It seems that we are crossroads of history. Changes is inevitable, but we must remember that we are having a system which has evolved over a very long time. We have a bench with an enviable legacy, a bar with a rich tradition and reputation, honest and industrious registry, persevering and inexhaustible team of advocate clerks. If one of these weakens, it would have adverse effect on the system. And the changes must be inclusive. We must also use this chance when the changes comes knocking at our doors to shed our shackles. It must be good time to give up hyper-technical approaches of weighing form over substance. We must not be just trying to change the bottle, we must change the wine too. Here the approach of the registry is very decisive. As the Registrar General of this Honorable Court, Justice Haribol was heading the change in the registry in a remarkable manner. Though the restriction put in place in the court premises causes inconvenience to the many of the stakeholders in the system, they can be rest assured that the restrictions are placed with a firm resolve to prevent the pandemic spread and not for depriving any facilities and privileges enjoyed by them. We are certain that this phase is temporary and those facilities and privileges will be restored at the earliest, and the court will resume its journey with all its majesty and glory. Born in an agricultural family at Paipad, to Sri M.N. Karunakaran Nayar and Srimati M.N. Rukmini Amma, Justice Haripal had obtained law degree from the Government Law College of Ernakulam in 1986. He joined the judicial service in 1987 and became a district judge in 2005. In January 2018, he was appointed as Registrar Subordinate Judiciary at the High Court. Subsequently, he was appointed as the Registrar General of the High Court in 2019. His Lordship has nearly 3 decades of judicial and administrative experience. The voyage commenced by His Lordship into the vast ocean of legal world as a second-class magistrate has now reached the stage of High Court judgeship, the highest judicial seat in the state. Journey to the top is not easy. It is worthwhile to quote the former President of India, Sri APJ Abdul Kalam, I quote, "Climbing to the top demands strength, whether it is to the top of Mount Everest or to the top of your career," unquote. Of late, it was feared that His Lordship may miss it between the cup and the lip, but the grace of Almighty succored. It is said that all is well that ends well. His Lordship had a warm relation with the Advocate Association and extended wholehearted cooperation in all its activities and stood with it through thick and thin. It is relevant to quote insightful words of one of the greatest legends of law, Sri Palkiwala. I quote, "Character is integrity plus altruism. Fame is a vapor, popularity an accident. Riches take wings, and those you cheer today will curse you tomorrow. And only one thing endures, character." Unquote. It is said that judge should illustrate perfect judicial manners, not the staid manner of silent gravity, nor even distant manner of Olympian aloofness, but the free and easy manner born out of the trust self-assurance, which do not sacrifice dignity and is always coupled with constant receptivity and abundance of vivaciousness. We are certain that Justice K. Haripal is endowed with character and competence and all these qualities and will have a successful tenure as judge of this honorable court. We wish His Lordship all success in His divine mission. I once again, on behalf of the Kerala High Court Advocate Association, welcome His Lordship and assure our wholehearted cooperation. Thank you. Jai Hind.
The Honorable Chief Justice and other Honorable Judges of the High Court, Sri C.P. Sudhakar Prasad, respected Advocate General, Sri R. Ashmi Narayan, Learning President of the Kerala High Court Advocates Association, Sri P. Vijayakumar, Learning Assistant Solicitor General of India, Sri N. Sugunabalan, President of the Senior Advocates Association, Sri Madhi S.K. Devi, President of the Kerala Women Lawyers Federation, other Senior Advocates present, Sri P.T. Ajit Kumar, Registrar Subordinate Judiciary and other registrars, my wife, son and other members of my immediate family, members of the profession, law officers of the state, my colleagues in the High Court, friends, ladies and gentlemen. I am extremely grateful for the kind words expressed by the respected Advocate General and Learned President of the Advocates Association. I am conscious that the statements are conventional, still encouraging. I express my gratitude for the cooperation offered to me by both the leaders of the bar. When I joined judicial service as judicial magistrate of the second class, the ultimate aim was to become a chief judicial magistrate. Thereafter, when I was selected as munsif, I could hopefully become a district judge at the most. When I was appointed to the higher judicial service, it was not even in my distant dreams that one day I would occupy this august office. These chance events were happened by mere chance and due to divine interventions. At the very outset, I must express my deep sense of gratitude to Honorable Justice Hrishikesh Roy, former Chief Justice of this court, who is presently a judge of the Honorable Supreme Court. Honorable Justice K. Surendra Mohan, presently President of the State Consumer Redressal Commission, and Honorable Justice P. R. Ramendra Menon, Chief Justice of the Chhattisgarh High Court, who formed the Collegium of the High Court, which recommended my name. I will cherish my good days in which I had worked as Registrar Subordinate Judiciary and then as Registrar General under His Lordship, Justice Hrishikesh Roy. His Lordship had complete trust and confidence in me. I believe that my recommendation was a clear gesture of the indulgence shown to me. It was agonizing that earlier my name did not come in the list of recommendees. My near relatives and well-wishers also were upset. At the same time, there were some remote signals that my name will be considered again. I am an ardent believer of Almighty God. Destiny cannot be changed. Ultimately, He disposed in my favor. I could perceive that God's own hands had worked for it. I express my gratitude from the bottom of my heart for the support and assistance given to me by Honorable Mr. Justice A. Hariprasad, Honorable Mr. Justice S. V. Bhatti, Honorable Mr. Justice N. Nagaresh of this court, Honorable Mr. Justice K. M. Joseph, Honorable Mr. Justice Ashok Bhushan, and Honorable Mr. Justice Mohan M. Shantanagoda of the Honorable Supreme Court. I do not have words to express my sincere gratitude to the Honorable Judges of the Supreme Court Collegium who cleared my name. I was always getting continued support and prayers from Honorable Mr. Justice Rishikesh Roy, Honorable Mr. Justice Thottathamby Radhakrishnan, Chief Justice of the Calcutta High Court, and Honorable Mr. Justice P. R. Ramachandran during these times. I do not have words to express the regard and consideration I was getting from the Honorable Chief Justice of the High Court. From the day I met His Lordship at his residence in Chennai till today, He has never considered me like a subordinate officer, but was giving me brotherly support and affection. When there was some skepticism about my elevation, His Lordship insisted nominating me as the chairman of the Permanent Law Adalat at Thiruvananthapuram for 5 years from 1/6/2020. He has also evolved in making my elevation faster. I take this opportunity to express my sincere gratitude to His Lordship. Similarly, I express my gratitude to Honorable Justice Antony Dimanki, former Chief Justice, and Honorable Justice P. N. Ravindran, who was my administrative judge in posting me as a registrar of this court. Both my parents are no more. It was they who taught me the virtues and principles in life, which stood me in good stead throughout my career. I bow before their memories with folded hands. My family is always the pillar of support to me. My wife Maya and son Krishnan always stand with me. In fact, behind the success of every judicial officer, there is equal or more degree of hardships and sacrifices on the part of the members of his family. My son had studied in nearly 10 schools when he completed his higher secondary. Still, both of them have managed to adapt for my sake. Similarly, all my siblings and members of the family also have supported us in building up my career. It was my elder brother Sri Radhakrishnan who initiated me to the High Court service, which paved way for this career progression. My father-in-law Sri Narendra Nayar, a former district judge, is instrumental in persuading me to appear for the municipal selection test. At that time, I was working as judicial first-class magistrate. Since proposal for integration between civil and criminal judiciary was on the pipeline, I was a bit complacent, since, like many other colleagues, for appearing for the test. But he compelled me and helped in making preparations. He is my friend, philosopher and guide. Similarly, my mother-in-law, younger brother, sister, sisters-in-law, brother-in-law, co-brother, and all other members in the family were supporting and encouraging me in abundance. I was getting unfettered support and cooperation from all sections and branches of the High Court. All the eight registrars were as a team. The administration of the High Court and subordinate judiciary could be run somewhat smoothly by their collective efforts. After the daily morning briefing with the Honorable Chief Justice, we interact and decide courses of action together. I take this opportunity to express my gratitude to colleague registrars Sarvasri P.D. Ajit Kumar, Sri K.P. Sudhir, Mathis K. Nilveli, A.V. Pradeep Kumar, K.K. Mohandas, Srimadhi N. Anita, and Sri Elias K. Abraham, and other officers of the High Court, Srimadhi C.S. Sudha, Addition Director of the Kerala Judicial Academy and her team, Sri Nisar Ahmad, Member Secretary, Kerala State Legal Services Authority, Sri Johnny Sebastian, Director, Kerala State Mediation Conciliation Center, Sri T.S. Arun, Public Relations Officer, Sri R. Ashok, Protocol Officer, Sri C.D. Thomas, Private Secretary to the Honorable the Chief Justice, and Sri Chadu Kevar, the Security Officer, were also doing commendable help to me. Sri S. Srikumar, former Protocol Officer, continues to help me even after his retirement on superannuation. Members of my personal staff, Sri Amrutraj K., then Second Officer, Sri M.K. Ranjit, Second Officer, Dr. Arun Kumar, T.T., Senior Grade Assistant, Sri Arun as Assistant, Sri Emil Babu, Personal Assistant, Sri Santosh T. Chauffeur, Sri Sumesh M.R. and Sri Vibin C.T. PSOs, Sri Gopakumar and Sri Jinuraj M. Office Attendants and Sri and Srimati Kartiyani were also of immense help to me in carrying out my duties. I have worked in 15 stations in different capacities in various parts of the state from Mattur to Thiruvananthapuram, besides in the Union Territory of Lakshadweep during the last 33 years. Even now I am in regular touch with the lawyers and staff members of these centers. I take this opportunity to convey my sincere gratitude and regard to all of them. Similarly, my fellow judicial officers also are very kind and considerate to me. Subordinate judiciary in the state is considered to be the best in the country. I am proud that I am part of that clan. For the last nearly 2.5 years, I had to be in constant touch with the respected Advocate General and other law officers of the state, and also Office Bearer of the High Court Advocates Association and the Clerks Association. I must say that I received cooperation in abundance from all. I should make special mention about the regard and consideration shown to me by the office bearers of the present situation, especially in the special circumstances which we have to make special arrangements for sitting, etc. I knew Sri Lakshminarayan for long, and all along he has been showing regard to me. Similarly, Advocate Sri Ramkumar Nambiar, President of the Association during 2018, and Sri Sunil Jacob Jose, who occupied the post during 2019, also were very kind to me. Whenever an advocate requiring intervention of the Registrar General, I could resolve it with ease by a mere phone call. I also acknowledge the cooperation rendered by Sri Ramachandran, President of the High Court Advocates Clerks Association. As Registrar General, I had to be in constant touch with the official hierarchy of the government and the district and police administration. I must make special mention about the positive responses I received from Sri Subrata Vishwas, former Additional Chief Secretary Home, which tempo was maintained by Dr. Vishwas Mehta, the present Additional Chief Secretary Home. Similarly, the Law Secretary Sri P.K. Ananda Babu and the District Collector Sri S. Suhas were always ready to act positively for the High Court on my call. I once again express my deep gratitude for the cooperation offered by the learned Advocate General and the President of the Advocates Association. I am fully conscious of my constraints and limitations. Notwithstanding the same, I would like to reiterate that I will try my level best to live up to your expectations and to stick to the oaths now taken. Thank you. Jai Hind.
The ceremony is complete.